Let's get started. Man, I lost.
Thank you. That feels nice. It's been a while, so it kind of makes me feel happy. Yeah. Oh, wow. I didn't expect to find such an authentic bathhouse all the way out here. What a pleasant surprise.
Now that I think about it, it's probably the principal's doing.
I heard this place was changed a lot when they renovated it into a dormitory. Apparently, it was once the mansion of a fallen noble family.
Oh yes, I've heard that same story.
It seems the family had to let go of their holdings 10 years ago after the head of the family was conned by an unscrupulous merchant. Though I heard they've since started up their own business outside the country.
I see.
Sheesh. How do you know all this stuff?
I feel like I've heard a story like that before.
Thank you. Hope you don't mind if we come in.
Oh, Instructor Toa!
Will you be joining us?
Not just her. I'll be joining you ladies as well.
Whoa!
An overwhelming presence.
Oh, I'm so sorry we've been hogging the bath.
Oh, not at all. I figured now would be a perfect chance to get to know my students better.
We'll try not to rain on your parade.
There's nothing like a nice soak in the bath after a long day. Seems like you girls were having quite the discussion in here. You all trying to get with Schwarzer?
Get with?
Yes, that's the plan.
That wasn't quite what we were talking about.
Well then, let me give you all some advice. He may seem polite and friendly, but he can actually be pretty single-minded, and at times outright stubborn. With that in mind, the best way to get your hooks in him is to set up just the right mood and lure him somewhere where you have the advantage.
Really?
Interesting.
For stubborn men, you need to set the right mood.
Be sure to take thorough notes, Elise.
Muse, please! Principal!
Good evening, everyone. It's time for Aubyn Time. It's 9 p.m. on June 11th, and you're listening to Radio Trista. How's this fine Sunday night treating you all out there? We're halfway through June, which means we're already halfway through the year. It's been a packed year, yet it's gone by in a flash. Speaking of June, it's that time again. That's right, the summer festival is upon us once more. It may be held a month later in Heimdall, but cities all over Erebonia are already having their own celebrations, each with their own unique customs. One of my personal favorite places to go for the summer festival is La Mer. Ordis is famous for their annual tradition of lighting candles and setting them to float in the bay. It's just breathtaking to see all those lights. Last year's lighting had to be canceled, unfortunately, but I'm sure plenty of people are looking forward to it this year. I know I am. I can already imagine it. Me sitting by the beach, drink in hand, watching a thousand glimmering lights float out to sea. It'd be wonderful to have such a luxurious, classy evening. There's more to Lemaire than just Ordis. The beaches are beautiful and bountiful, and the seafood is so fresh, it practically leaps off the plate at you. Raquel is well known for its casinos and theaters, and there's also the scenic Brionia Island. There aren't any regularly scheduled ferries there, but if you do make it, you'll find a hidden gem rich in nature and ancient ruins. So after the summer festival, you can go for a swim, hit up the casinos, win a boat, then explore some ruins. There, I planned your whole trip for you.
Maybe this is a good opportunity, then. Emma did ask me to tell you about her. Listen up. I'm going to tell you a little about the Hexen Clan. And the two sisters, Emma and Vita. They were the youngest members of a clan hidden away from the world at large. Vita lost her parents when she was young. But due to her immense natural talents, she was taken in by the Elder as her top disciple. Meanwhile, Emma's mother was what we refer to as a stray witch. She lived among the common people. However, she lost her life in an accident. Emma was also taken in by the Elder, and the two girls were raised together like sisters. The Elder created a familiar for each of them, me and Grianos. Vita was full of talent and spirit, but Emma was a shy shut-in. They both grew into strong, noble witches, and they would have lived a peaceful life in the village, but at the age of 16, Vita volunteered to become a wandering witch. A wandering witch's job is to go to the outside world and report back to the village on new developments. The Elder sent her off with full confidence, but within half a year, she had vanished. We now know why. The Grand Master of Ouroboros got to her. She joined that den of snakes and abandoned her duties as a witch. The Elder regretted her decision to let Vita leave the village. It wasn't the first time she'd seen this happen, after all. But Emma was devastated by the disappearance of her sister. From that day, Emma began training and studying as hard as she could with one goal: become a wandering witch herself to bring Vita back. And so, Emma was permitted to leave the village at the age of 16. With the help of some stray witches, she was able to enroll at Thor's with a scholarship. And in the spring of her first semester, she met you guys. I'm not supposed to talk about this sort of thing with outsiders, but by this point, everyone in Class 7 is pretty much family. Emma had to work hard for the Elder to okay this. Tell her yourself. You'll be seeing her again before too long, right?
And that'll do it for tonight's show. Good night, everyone. As for you two, don't stay up too late. You need your beauty rest, Celine and Reed.
What an obnoxious woman.
I'm sure she predicted we'd be listening and used her magic to ensure only we could hear that last part. Yeah, Emma's no slouch, but Vita's power as a witch is tremendous. That said, she's not omnipotent. After all, Osborne pulled the rug out from under her, and now she's on the run from her former friends. Yeah, and about how she failed to change the ending. It must have something to do with the Infernal Castle. Vita's personality may be one big joke, but she's not the type to lie. There's no doubt we have a crisis looming over us. Yeah, consider it a farewell gift. Even though you need to rely on that pendant, you'll be able to control your power now. I'll leave with your sister tomorrow morning. I suppose the next time we'll see each other is when Class 7 meets up. Hell no!